Another wonderful statue in the Egyptian Museum is the statue of the king Montahat ibn Hapitra. The king Montahat ibn Hapitra is a very important king in the Egyptian history as ruled Egypt approximately in the year 2000 before Christ. The statue is really second to none as you see. The statue is really wonderful. It's black, yeah, but it has a meaning. This black color means that he is dead. He's waiting for resurrection. In fact, in Egypt, in ancient Egypt, there were three signs of indicating that he's waiting for resurrection, that he is dead. First is the black color, second is the hands in the position or the arms in the position of the mummy, as you see here in front of you. So this means also that he's waiting for resurrection. Third sign is the bird when it's curved, so it means that he's waiting for resurrection or the statue is dead. This made, normally it's understood as it's made after his death for him for his funerary temple, for instance, something like that. Here we have the three signs together. We have the black color, we have the bird which is curved, we have here the arms in the position of the mummy. So he is totally dead as you see here in front of you. In fact, the statue is really magnificent, and as you see, as you said, it's a masterpiece in the Egyptian Museum. It's also important because it indicates a very important king who has ruled Egypt in the what we call it the Middle Kingdom period. He is the founder, in fact, of the Middle Kingdom period. The Middle Kingdom period has two dynasties in Egypt, 11th and 12th dynasty. And in fact, we consider him as the second important liberator of Egypt. He's a very important personality in the Egyptian history because he reunified Egypt once again for the second time. We have spoken previously, about the king Mina or Dauma in the first dynasty, 3200 before Christ. We've spoken that he has, we started the Egyptian history with him, and in fact he has unified the both lands of Egypt, Upper and Lower Egypt, on year 3200 before Christ. For the second time this occurred in the era of this king, the king Montahat ibn Hapitra. We know that the first, what we call it in history, in the first intermediate period, 11th and 12th dynasty, he has reunified Egypt. He's the founder of this period, as I said. And before that, immediately, there was what we call it the first intermediate period, in which Egypt was again separated into two lands, and he reunified Egypt for a second time. So the first one is the king Mena, or Narmer, 3200 before Christ, and the king Montahat ibn Hapitra. And the third important person or personality in this period, in this field, is the king Amasis or Ahmos on years 1570, and he reunified Egypt again after liberating it from the Hyksos. The statue is black. The statue has very huge legs here, and this has so many interpretations, in fact, and so many opinions in the field of Egyptology. Some people thought that maybe it's just a mistake, something like that, but we don't consider that because the Egyptians have made wonderful statues and wonderful pieces of art cannot make such a tiny mistake. I'm sorry to say, but some people say stupid mistake. No, it's not possible. So we can say that it's meant. It's meant, and most likely, also we cannot consider the opinion that said, it was realistic, because it was not the time of realism, of being realistic. For instance, when we speak about being realistic, we can speak about the period of Akhenaten, for instance. Some people, a school, special school, attributes the statues of Akhenaten to his being realistic, but in fact, this is what he was not like that, most likely. Some people said about the
Fantasy's disease.
Most likely he is, it's just symbolic. It means that he's so fixed upon the throne. We know that he is the founder of a new dynasty, and that's why we think it's very symbolic. It means that he is, you know, in the German language, for instance, we have a special proverb or a special term that says that er steht auf festem Boden. Auf Deutsch, er steht auf festem Boden. It means that he is very well seated. He is very well established. The same thing exists in all languages. For instance, in French, you say, for instance, il est bien assis. Which means that he is very well seated. So he is very well seated on his throne. He is the founder of a new dynasty. He's a very important king in the Egyptian history. His name is the king Montahat ibn Hapitra, and he ruled Egypt approximately near 1900 before Christ.